Being in this industry for a long time, the FDA has tried to take away a lot of these natural products that have been really effective for people.
So this is not the first time this has happened.
No, this is definitely not the first time it's happened. I have lost a lot of products that I've had a lot of great effect for my patients that were helping my patients a lot. And especially in the cancer realm, it might be because of competition. It might be because it's being talked about a lot for that thing that's going around. It might be because it's becoming a much more popular supplement and lots of people are starting to take it. And now the FDA, it's on FDA's radar and wasn't really on their radar now. And now they are like looking into this and be like, whoa, tons of people are taking this.
You're watching the Dr. Jake podcast.
Hi everyone, welcome back. I am Teresa. I'm a mom, I'm a health nut, I'm a wife to a cancer fighter, and I'm here with Dr. Jake to give you an update on the NAC ban. I know that we've come out with a number of videos talking about this. It's generated a ton of interest, and there's a lot of comments in there about people going, what? This doesn't seem like it's true. I'm still able to find it. Is this a hoax? What's going on? And even some just other fear-based, you know, comments out there. So we want to give you guys an update as of right now, November, where we're at, November 2021, where we're at with this, so that you know are filled with that knowledge and know how to handle the future here. Dr. Jake?
Yeah, so it'll be good to give some clarity to this NAC ban and go more detail into it so people can be not as confused about what's going on.
Exactly. But before we dive into that, we want to remind everyone that's watching today that this is just a podcast, right, Dr. Jake?
Yeah, so this is just a podcast. We're not going to give any treatment advice or anything like that. So if you want to set up an appointment and go detail into whatever's going on with you, you could give our website a visit at integrativemedica.com. Find our phone number there, give our staff a call and set up an appointment with me or some of my wonderful other doctors I have at the practice.
Wonderful. All right, let's dive into this. So the first question really here is NAC actually banned?
That is a good question. It's not necessarily that you can't get it. It's not necessarily other companies aren't deciding to do it. The FDA is saying that they're going to want to ban it. And they're saying to companies, hey, you guys should stop making this because we are going to ban it. And they're not necessarily saying they're absolutely going to fine them, but they're kind of saying it does. So this is kind of how it works in the beginning when they decide they're going to take away a product that has been around for decades. It's not going to be immediate, but they're going to give warning numbers, get ready for this, that this is going to happen and we're working on trying to take this away. So that's what's going on right now. And many companies have decided to take it off the market. And other companies decided, hey, I'm not going to listen to the FDA right now. It's not necessarily banned right now. I'm going to continue making it so people can still get this until it really is an issue. Because it's not necessarily absolutely banned and you're going to get in big trouble if you do it. That's not where it's at right now. But like Amazon has decided to take it off. You can't find NAC there. There's many other popular supplemental products that are changing their products to more L-cysteine over N-acetyl-cysteine. Yeah, that's what's going on in that regard.
So it seemed like what happened was in May, I believe it was May of this summer, the FDA issued out a warning letter to supplement companies, basically in layman's terms saying, hey, you are not legally allowed to sell this supplement as a supplement because back in the 60s, it was used as a drug. And with some of the laws and details of how the FDA works, if that happens, then it can't ever really be used as a supplement. Basically, they warned him like, you can't be doing this. Am I clear on that?
Yeah, that's where it's coming from. I don't know how the FDA is really saying that type of stuff because it's been around a really long time. Now they're trying to make it like it's a drug so it only could be prescribed by physicians. But again, it's not necessarily illegal yet. And these companies might get in trouble and they might get a fine. But some companies are willing to do it and some companies aren't. And that's why you're seeing some companies selling it and some companies not. And some states you're able to get it more than other states.
Now, there's some talk in the comment sections that why did this happen now? Why after 40, 50 years, 60 years, however long, I'm not the best mathematician over here, Dr. Jake, would now this be an issue where all of a sudden now they're issuing out this warning letter? And there's definitely some rumors and some talk that this is related to that thing that's going around and other types of future drugs that they want to come out with, and so you got to get rid of the supplements first so that they can do this. Do you have any thoughts or knowledge on why, what would trigger something like this to happen now?
Not anything for sure. This theoretical reasons behind it, but being in this industry for a long time, the FDA has tried to take away a lot of these natural products that have been really effective for people.
So this is not the first time this has happened.
No, this is definitely not the first time it's happened. I have lost a lot of products that I've had a lot of great effect for my patients that were helping my patients a lot. And especially in the cancer realm, it might be because of competition. It might be because it's being talked about a lot for that thing that's going around. It might be because it's becoming a much more popular supplement and lots of people are starting to take it. And now the FDA, it's on FDA's radar and wasn't really on their radar now. And now they are like looking into this and be like, whoa, tons of people are taking this. Let's look into it. And they might make say that it's maybe unsafe or whatever, but there's no good research out there that says any NAC is not effective or it's going to harm other people. It's been used for decades, you know? So those are just some things that are potentials. Obviously, these are all just theoretical and could potentially be conspiracy theories. Who knows?
But this has been done with other ones before that had nothing to do with the thing that's going around. This is just, this is something that the FDA does a lot with other things. Yeah, now I know that some people are trying to fight this. And so you were telling me before we were talking today that there's a process, right? Starts with a warning letter. As we can see, everyone responds differently. There's companies like Amazon that just get ahead of the game and they're like, okay, we're done with it. Others that go, nope, I'm not done with it until you officially ban it. And then others that are kind of preparing for the future. They're starting to, any new bottles that they're coming out with, they're switching out the ingredients with something that is legally allowed to use as a supplement. And then now what's happening at this point is that the Senator of Utah, Senator Lee, did request a hearing with the FDA to go over this. They're very concerned about it. They've got a number of doctors that can come up and speak on it and speak as to why this should not be happening. And the FDA has since denied it. That was an update that I was reading with, I think that came out in August, that the FDA denied the hearing. So when that happens, what typically happens next? And since you've seen this happen with a number of supplements before, what's the process really like? You start with a warning letter. Some people try to request hearings. Sometimes there's hearings, sometimes there's not. In regards to other types of supplements and protocols out there, what happens next?
The only thing that can absolutely change what the FDA does is the Congress needs to get together, see that's an issue. They see that this is governmental overreach and the Congress stops the FDA. But the FDA is a separate entity and they really decide to do whatever they want. And I have had colleagues of mine and scientists that I know go and talk to the FDA at hearings to really discuss what's really going on with all these different supplements that have been lost in our formulary and what we're seeing with patients and talking about the research, the literature, side effect profile, really going in detail. And in many instances, the FDA just decides no matter what, they're just going to ban something. They just decide to ban it and they don't really have good reason for it in many instances. It's really sad, especially when they're banning certain natural products. They just say it's unsafe. We think it's unsafe. The public shouldn't have availability to this. We're going to take it off the market. So I hope this doesn't happen with NAC, but I've seen it with a lot of stuff. And I really hope our government will see that this is a real big problem. Why are they taking away a product that has been used for decades, that has benefits and good research for several different medical conditions with very limited side effects? It's almost a pretty natural product. It's just cysteine with an acetyl group added to it. Yeah, so that's my comments on that.
Now, you in reference to me that this also could affect NAD. I don't know what NAD is. Can you let our audience know what the relationship is?
Yeah, the only reason I was stating that is that that's another product that the FDA is going after too. They're trying to eliminate NAD also. And actually they have eliminated that for IV use right now. It's really difficult to find. And that's just recently happened in the past couple months. So I'm very familiar with the FDA taking away effective therapies that for my patients.
Now, is NAD, sounds like NAC. It's just one
NAD
letter, a similar supplement?
NAC, yeah, they have similar, they sound similar, right? But they're completely different products. NAD is a product that helps with, it's niacin. It's the activated form of niacin. And it's really great for stimulating mitochondria healing and stimulation of that. And it can be really good for, it's used a lot for addictions, but I use it for mitochondrial repair and addictions. So it's taken away really one of the most effective therapies that we have for addiction. That the FDA's taken it away. Like, I haven't seen anything as powerful as NAD for that.
And
it has to be done IV to have the effect.
So is it, when you find that these things happen, is there, they're typically like a follow-up to that where a prescription drug does come out that's like a competitor?
Yeah, this happens all the time. So
is there like a prescription that's come
out?
I
won't go in big detail there, but yes, I've seen this on at least a handful of recent things in the past couple years that certain herbs and things that we're doing IV form, there's a drug coming out that's that specific herb just modified slightly. So it's kind of taken away the competition market. So it's interesting.
Now, is this often triggered by, I know that there's like with the world of supplements, right? If it's not an FDA, if it's not a controlled substance or something that is prescribed by a doctor, it seems like the rule is that the supplement companies and distributors are not allowed to say that this particular supplement can cure or treat any particular disease or illness and so forth.
For sure.
So is it that these problems happen because these companies are making these statements that are not allowed, or are they not making the statements and it's still happening? Can you speak on that?
I think it happens because yes, some supplement companies do start not really following the rules. Or certain healthcare practitioners start not following the rules and start saying that these things are cures too. So I think it's both on the supplemental company and possibly on the healthcare provider making claims.
Is there a way to kind of just explain it to the general community? Obviously, you know, you're a doctor and you've got a lot more knowledge than a lot of us, but like, is there a reason why supplements are not allowed? Like, why can you, with a prescription, you can say this helps cure that, but you can't say that with a supplement?
Because the FDA has approved that drug. That's why. The only reason why.
So why doesn't the FDA approve supplements?
Drug, they can say, oh yeah, it's used for this specific condition. Why does the FDA not approve turmeric or boswellia or NAC for that matter? Good question, because there is extensive research on fish oil and turmeric and frankincense and all these other herbs for various conditions, and they should, but I don't know. Good question. I don't know why they don't when there's extensive research for it. Maybe because it's not regulated, and you can't put a patent on a specific turmeric, for example, because it's a food. So there's all kinds of people that can make turmeric, and the FDA doesn't regulate that all turmerics are FDA approved. They would approve a specific product. You know what I mean? That's what they do.
So because they can't control every aspect of it, then it leaves too much room for not being able to officially say this is, because it doesn't have all the controls that they have. Okay, mm-hmm. That makes sense. Yep. Mm-hmm. Well, I appreciate you giving us the update. And I know that when we get any official answers on like anything new that comes up on this whole NAC ban, we will get you guys the newest information so that you can plan accordingly. In the meantime, if you have companies that you found that are able to, that are still supplying NAC, or want to switch to L-cysteine, there's still options out there. We do have a video where Dr. Dick does come out and talk a little bit about the option for a prescription if you do find that you're struggling to start finding it. So make sure and check out that video. In the meantime, Dr. Jake, how can people follow you?
Just visit our website, integrativemedica.com. Give us a call, talk to my receptionist, and they will refer you to me or one of my great other doctors, and also just keep on listening to our podcast.
Wonderful. All right. Thank you so much, Dr. Jake, and everyone else. We'll see you next week.
All right.
Hey, Dr. Jake, thank you for your time today. And if you enjoyed the show, then do us a favor and leave a review. It helps more people to find the show, which could save their life. And remember, this is a podcast and should not replace personalized attention from a medical professional like Dr. Jake. If you or someone you know has been diagnosed with an autoimmune disorder, cancer of any stage, or a life-changing illness, visit our website today and schedule a virtual appointment with one of our doctors who can lead you to a treatment plan in your area. That's integrativemedica.com. Integrative, M-E-D-I-C-A.com.
Thank you for listening to the Integrative Medica podcast with Dr. Jake. To hear past episodes and get alerts for the future, subscribe to us on your favorite podcasting platform and be sure to follow us on YouTube as well. Just search for Integrative Medica with Dr. Jake.